everybody tells you to use accomplishment or achievement-based statements on your resume, but nobody tells you how. By the end of this video, you will know exactly how to turn your job duties into measurable results and accomplishments so that you can build a winning resume. Let's get started. But first, for expert advice and all the tools that you need to land your dream job, subscribe to my channel. I post weekly content that will help you along every step on your journey towards landing that dream job. Come here for actionable advice and tips that you can put into place today to make progress in your job search. Click that subscribe button and hit the bell to be notified whenever I drop a new video. I don't want you to miss a beat. At Hired Institute, we have expert resume writers that work with job seekers to actually build outstanding resumes so that they can land their dream jobs. And one of the main areas that most of our clients struggle with is adding accomplishment statements or measurable results to describe their work experience. And I'm sure if you are watching this video, you want to know exactly how you can build those accomplishment statements. And I want to help you with just that. So it's important that we first classify the difference between a responsibility-based statement versus an accomplishment-based statement. A responsibility-based statement answers the question, what were you hired to do? Think about the job description when you were hired. These descriptions detail what you were hired to do, your job duties, what you do on the job. And on the opposite side, accomplishment-based statements, also known as achievement-based or measurable results, answer the question, what did you achieve? What was the result? What did you accomplish? So you have your job duty, and because you did that, on the other side, what did you achieve? To create strong accomplishment statements on your resume, use this formula. Strong action verb, result, timeline, and an explanation. Again, it's a strong action verb to start, what the result was, what is the timeline that you achieved that result, and then a short explanation. Let's look at an example. So a job duty for a marketing manager could be to lead the marketing department and create ongoing campaigns for customers. Now, I would ask you, what is the measurable result of that duty? So because you're a marketing manager and you lead a marketing department or a team and you're running ongoing campaigns for customers, what is the outcome? What is the result of your work? And a measurable result or accomplishment for this example of a marketing manager could be drove $5 million increase in new business over 6 months through new outreach campaigns. So here, drove is a strong action verb. The result is a $5 million increase in new business. The timeline is over 6 months. And the explanation how they did it was through new outreach campaigns. So here we can clearly see how we went from just a job duty or regular responsibility to an accomplishment statement that details the result or the outcome of performing a certain job duty. So at this point, some of you might be thinking, and I get this a lot, Cindy, what if I didn't achieve anything on the job? What if I had no accomplishments or achievements? And I'm gonna challenge you to think about the answers to the following questions to help you build those strong accomplishment statements. Did you increase sales or productivity or volume? Provide a percentage or amount. Did you generate new business or increase the client base? How? What were the circumstances? Did you forge affiliations, partnerships, or alliances that impacted the company's success? With who and what were the results? Did you decrease cost or increase revenue? By how much over what time period? Did you design or institute any new system or process? If so, what were the results? Did you save management or your supervisor time? Did you bring in any project under budget? The answers to these 7 questions are your accomplishments or your measurable results. So take some time to reflect, write down the answers to these questions as you start thinking about generating those strong, impactful accomplishment statements for your resume. And so to recap, make sure that you are using accomplishment statements on your resume. Employers want to see measurable results. They want to see that you can generate an outcome and not just perform a job. Make sure that you use this formula to generate strong, impactful accomplishment statements. Strong action verb, the result, a timeline, and an explanation. Don't put the explanation in the beginning. Start with that strong action verb and the result, and then explain how you got to that result. Remember to use strong action verbs, as this can really help to add that next level of impact to your resume. Okay, so you've created these strong, impactful accomplishment statements. What's next? Download my free guide, the Standout Candidate Toolkit, for more steps and strategies to help you be the standout candidate that you are, to get noticed by employers and actually get hired. A link to the free download is in the description of this video. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more valuable content on how you can land your dream job. Comment any career-related questions that you have, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.